is a league based on developing schemes, creating and establishing an identity, and then finding ways to pivot off of those elements when defenses begin to make adjustments to catch up. Everyone knows Kyle Shanahan is going to give defenses headaches with heavy doses of play-action passes each and every Sunday. The core of this offense is the zone running game, which features inside and outside zone runs. When the defense begins to over-pursue on these zone runs, Shanahan mixes in gap scheme runs like counter to play off an overly aggressive defense. Defending the 49ers' running game is a pain in the ass in itself, but their play-action pass packages make their offense a complete and utter nightmare. This play-action attack takes advantage of defenders drawn towards the line of scrimmage who are cheating up to stop the run. The 49ers' play-action pass packages are designed to stretch every single part of the football field. They'll flip play-action screens to the running backs off either tackle, ghost and jet motion fakes from the wide receivers, alternate fullbacks and tight ends blocking or running routes, while any position player might be flying right towards you as you chase someone without the ball. Shanahan kept the Steelers in base personnel to stop their defensive back blitzes. A blitz is categorized as five rushers or more. The Steelers had the fourth highest percentage of defensive back blitzes in 2018 at 14%, while also having the fourth highest percentage of blitzes in the entire NFL. The Steelers brought five or more on 20 of the 49ers' 32 pass attempts. This played right into the 49ers' play-action pass-heavy attack, where they are first in the NFL in play-action usage with 40%. Against the Steelers, they utilized play-action 45% of their plays, which was the third highest in one game for any team in 2019. They knew the Steelers were bringing the blitz. And what works best for the blitz? Play-action passes. They were fully prepared to punish the attacking, blitz-heavy Steelers defense. It was clear that the Steelers were selling out to stop this potent ground game. But as the game slogged on, and the zone runs mixed with counters which played off of those runs started to wear the defense down, play action is the dagger that cuts through a tired defense. Let's first look at one of the 49ers zone runs from this game so you can see what kind of a bind the Steelers linebackers are put into when trying to defend this play action attack. Offensive linemen in a zone running scheme take a read step play side to try and push the defenders towards the sideline. Running backs are coached to make one cut and get upfield quickly, based off angles and creases created along the offensive line. The linebackers have to pursue these gaps and clog the available cutback lanes to stop the zone run. Counter runs are a gap scheme run, whereas zone runs are zone schemes. Counters aren't new to the Shanahan offense, but the frequency in which they are being called has risen dramatically in 2019. Shanahan knows teams' main focus when game planning is stopping his zone run scheme, so he pivots off of his tendencies. When you go one way, he goes the other. The counter is designed to look like their inside zone run to the left. The backside blockers are all blocking down the line towards what appears to be play side. As the play starts, Garoppolo opens to his left. The fullback and the running back each take a step to the left, which to the defense looks like inside zone. However, what was the playside guard, and is now the backside guard, pulls away from his position to lead the run the other way. Here, the fullback leads the way with that guard, creating a hole for the running back. When the defense overcompensates for this zone run, the counter attacks that overcompensation. So, how does Shanahan's play action take advantage of an amped up Steelers defense that is anxious to stop the run? Using the same fly motion from the wide receiver, and then the same ghost motion once again, this is window dressing to trick the defense. As the play starts, the defense sees the offensive line using zone blocking techniques. The linebackers flow towards what they think is play side to cut off the run. Even after the fake, the wide receiver's ghost motion keeps the linebacker's eyes in the backfield for just a split second longer. To look at the route combination of this play and how the pass is married to the run, we see the offense is running the Yankee concept, a concept I've broken down in past episodes. The X receiver at the top of the screen will run a clear out 9 route or a deep post to clear out the cornerback and safety, while a deep crossing route will fill that created void. As this play starts, Kittle begins to cut across the defense on the shallow cross. Linebacker Devin Bush doesn't know if Kittle is going to blow him up with a block, so naturally, he jumps inside to avoid him. You can tell a linebacker is undisciplined and poorly coached when they backpedal instead of completely flipping their hips to find the crossing route on play action. Here's an example of a play unique to both Kyle Shanahan's scheme and this 49ers offense. There are only a few teams that even roster a fullback, and the 49ers are the only team that can utilize their fullback, Kyle Juszczyk, as a vertical threat. Here, the 49ers fake the left inside zone run, which once again causes the defenses to over-pursue. This puts linebacker Mark Barron in a brutal predicament. Almost every time a fullback charges directly at you, he's getting ready to blast your knees off. But Juszczyk is a different breed. By capitalizing on the linebacker's over-pursuit, Juszczyk swims past him and runs a fullback fade outside of the numbers and up the sideline for a huge gain. Shanahan knows how to prey on an overcommitted defense and how to attack their weaknesses. The 49ers have wide receiver Marquise Goodwin out wide in a max split, with Kyle Juszczyk in the slot. Wide receiver Deebo Samuel is inside both of them and motions to the backfield into a split back formation. Shanahan knows with this motion that all eyes will be trained on Samuel. A flare screen to Samuel would make sense. Due to his motion into the backfield and a fullback being positioned in the slot, it's hard for the Steelers not to want to jump the screen. The Steelers bring a blitz with five pass rushers. They are gearing up for a quick pass due to their blitz, so they anticipate the ball will come out fast. As the play starts, Deebo flares out. The two receivers appear to initiate blocks, and the linebacker is in hot pursuit. But this is not a flare screen. Jimmy Garoppolo pump fakes, and with the aggressive linebacker and safety completely buying the screen, Juszczyk is left wide open up the seam where he attempts to banish Minkah Fitzpatrick to the upside down, which honestly could also be back to Miami. I went back and studied the 49ers' first two games again to see if Shanahan knew the Steelers were going to pick up on tape that when the offense motions from this trips alignment to a split back formation with a flare screen, but no. There was no goddamn reason for such over-aggression, just a flat-out undisciplined defense. On the very next play, the Steelers line up in a 6-2 defense, six men on the line of scrimmage with two linebackers. They do this to combat the wide zone run. By adding extra defenders on the line of scrimmage, this plugs each gap and reduces open lanes for cutbacks. Garoppolo sees this pre-snap, so he audibles to fake the zone run, which they are gearing up for, and punishes them with a play-action pass. Here is the Yankee concept once again. It's used again and again because of how difficult it is to stop paired with a potent ground game. Shanahan and Sean McVay perfected this play a few years back during their time with the Redskins. Usually, the X receiver runs a clear out nine route or a deep post, which takes both the cornerback and the safety with him. However, safety Terrell Edmonds has seen this concept a few times already, so he's beginning to cheat over from his weak safety position towards the strong side of the formation in an attempt to take away that crossing route. This exposes the deep middle of the field to the clear out receiver who could alert his route by cutting into that vacated zone for a big gain, something we will see in just a bit. The Steelers' defense, namely their two linebackers, completely bite on this play action. Devin Bush is supposed to turn his head completely around to quickly get to his landmark, which is the field side hash, to try and find that crossing route. But instead, he backpedals and Garoppolo throws it over his head. A quarter later, once again, to counter the Steelers' 6-2 defense, the 49ers dial up Yankee off of a fake outside zone to the left. The entire 8-man box is completely sucked into the play fake. The Steelers are finally ready to counter this concept. Edmonds has cheated towards the strong side of the formation to take away Goodwin's crosser. As Marquise Goodwin starts to stem towards the middle of the field on his crossing route, cornerback Joe Hayden instantly recognizes this concept. He looks across the field and sees Deebo Samuel taking off deep. He knows in this coverage that once Edmonds takes the deep cross in Yankee, the deep middle third will have a gaping void in it. Hayden sees Samuel streaking down the field. Now that Goodwin is being taken by the safety, he parallels Samuel's route to protect the deep part of the field. Samuel widens out the stem of his route and attacks the cornerback's outside leverage to gain an advantage on the inside. Instead of a clear out route, he instead is running a deep post to attack the vacated deep middle third. Garoppolo sees the safety jump the crosser, and Samuel establishing himself inside to win on the deep post, but doesn't recognize Hayden breaking from Goodwin to rob Samuel deep. This has been a recurring issue in past weeks with Garoppolo. For example, the interception he threw against Cincinnati in Week 2, he had what looked like a wide-open receiver, Richie James, but failed to recognize the cornerback dropping off his man in zone. Garoppolo gathers and chucks the ball 55 yards downfield. Samuel does a great job high-pointing the ball over Hayden, but can't come down with the catch. Despite the risky nature of this play and Hayden's brilliant recognition of the deep post, this was a fantastic play call pivoting off the in-game tendencies of the Steelers' defense. Later in the third quarter, the offense mixes their formations up a bit to try and produce an explosive play. In all the film I've charted, I have never seen an offense neutralize hook zone linebackers like the Niners do. These dig, deep over, and glance routes absolutely killed the Steelers all afternoon. The offense positions their two receivers in a stack alignment on the boundary side of the formation. This concept is called slice. Goodwin is running a slice route directly at the safety to clear out the middle of the field for the dig. It's the left inside zone play action fake that empties the entire field for the 49ers and creates a 2-on-2 matchup deep down the field. The two defenders are playing soft coverage because of the speed of the 49ers receivers. Usually, for a dig route to work, the offense will create a high-low read. The low read is often a drag route or a hook from another receiver, so that the defense will bite on the low read to open up a passing lane for the deeper route. Here, the 49ers use play action as their low read. I mean, look at what this does to the defense. Nobody has any idea what is going on. As the game progressed, Shanahan moved away from the crossers and Yankee concept because finally the linebackers were dropping to their landmarks after they read the play action. This is why Shanahan is on another level as a play caller and is a special NFL mind. Every call sets the defense up to be taken advantage of, whether it be the next play, series, quarter, or half. The defense will see a play that looks like something they've seen before, but is actually a pivot off of that. The receivers line up once again in their stack formation on the left. The deep coverage has just seen the slice route with the backside dig, so what do the receivers do? Goodwin stems inside towards the safety as if he's running slice again, but instead cuts outside on a deep out route. Samuel stems outside looking as if he's taking a wide angle to cut hard inside on another dig route, but instead he head fakes inside and runs the corner deep and out of the play. Both defenders are expecting the slice dig concept, which leaves Goodwin wide open. Trying to defend this 49ers play action attack is flat out devastating. If you sell out to stall this zone blocking scheme, fill the gaps, and penetrate a field, Shanahan will simply dice you up all over the place. The more you hang back for the inevitable routes whizzing behind you, the running game will slowly cut you deeper and deeper. This scheme has proven to work for years. It spanned multiple teams, multiple types of personnel, and has produced quality offenses with varying levels of talent. All of this has culminated in Shanahan landing in San Francisco, where he has what looks to be his franchise quarterback. The 49ers' success is mounting, the wins are starting to pile up at 3-0, and yet Shanahan and Garoppolo are just getting started. Thank you so much for watching this week's episode. If you want to support the channel, make sure to subscribe and turn those notifications on. Follow me on Twitter at AlexRollinsNFL, and drop me a comment so we can talk some ball. All right, see you next week. Later.